Cool. I think we're recording. Now, more second guessing myself with this recording system that I got going on is because I can't actually see myself on screen. I just got this little indicator down at the bottom that shows me that I'm recording, but I've ran into problems in the past where the screen's frozen. So I'd hate to make a video an hour long or 90 minutes as I've done so in the past, and I'm just recording a still frozen screen. Anyway, I probably said off the top of my head that I wasn't going to do anything over the weekend, but like, in all seriousness, this is just going to be like a chilled out video posted Sunday night. It's better than watching A Current Affair or some movie you've seen 10 times on 7 Mate. So jump in, join me on this one. And the reason I'm doing a video titled Donald Trump Invited Us on Trump Force One is because I actually watched the Joe Rogan podcast yesterday with Donald Trump. It was about 3 hours long, watched the entirety of it. There were some good talking points. It actually wasn't as interesting as I hoped it would be, but it was still worth watching and checking out. This video is about 5 days old, and I watched a few minutes of it. I found it pretty amusing, rather funny. I'll interject, pause the video where need be, where there's something to say. There was some rather comedic, meme-like moments, we'll put it that way. And if you've noticed any of my tabs up here, as I said, this will be a bit free-flowing. Kind of like Donald Trump, kind of like the Don himself. He likes to, I think as he put it, unwind things. So he can just go from one topic to another, and he just seamlessly seems to wind into it, as I'm about to do with Brian Johnson, Blueprint, and Olive Oil. But on that note, who is Brian Johnson? Yeah, he's the guy you might have seen on 60 Minutes. He wants to, claims he wants to live forever. He wants to stop the process of aging and essentially turn back the clock. Now, I'm particularly fascinated about some of the stuff he says regarding health and the importance of certain nutrient intakes, exercise, remedies that you can use for your hair, skin, nails, and ways that you can adjust your diet. While I don't entirely stand by the premise of reversing aging and ultimately preventing, say, death, I'm not a big believer of that. I think, yeah, we're all in the mortal coil and it's going to happen. It's unavoidable. But there is still some things that I like taking away from it to self-improve. And on that note, I don't want to be the kind of channel that always goes on about the same thing. Women this, women that, how to read women, how to approach women, how to talk to women. I actually remember saying this to my mum. So it's funny enough, like even my mum sometimes checks out a video or two that I do. And not that there was any particular criticism from her. It's just that I told her that I don't want to be the kind of channel that men watch, whether it's every now and then or they're subscribed, and it's always just the rattling off the same old shit, the same old shit. Yeah, I think by now men generally know to go to the gym, and there's only so many videos you can watch on how to pick up chicks and how to understand chicks and female psychology. I want to start leaning into different areas that men can still use to better develop themselves. Some information, pockets of information that they can take out. Okay, yeah, maybe I'll try that. Maybe I'll do my own research, my own due diligence, delve into that sort of topic. Something that you might even discover, something that you take away that you start looking into on your own accord. So here, like extra virgin olive oil, something I've been doing now myself for the last couple of weeks, and the reason I've got some tabs open is for context, but I did look into for the first time today into Brian Johnson's extra virgin olive oil, and holy whack-a-mole, 65, and it's .com, so it's not even AU, it's not an AU store, there's no AU anywhere in that URL. I don't even know if he would post, please Brian, no pop-ups. 65 USD is batshit crazy for a 750ml bottle of olive oil. And what I don't particularly like about this is that he says here in the description of the benefits of polyphenol and what sort of count it should contain, But when you actually gloss over, I should say delve into his nutritional facts, the actual label of his snake oil, ironically, olive oil, I'm not going to say it's outright bullshit, but seriously, for that price, that's about 100 AUD, Australian dollars, and he doesn't actually even have a nutritional breakdown. He might not think that's significant, but you go over to some Aussie olive oil from Cobram Estate, so that's an Australian manufacturer. I think there's a processing plant in Lara, or maybe that's where the farm is. But here they've got nutritional information, which actually breaks down antioxidants and vitamin E, biophenols, which is really just an interchangeable term for polyphenols. And it's a lot more transparent for a smaller bottle, sure, but 25, and it's AUD, it's not USD. It's probably like 17 USD equivalent. And you can actually find this, and you don't have to get it posted from like Woolworths and Coles. It's there. It's on the expensive side, but having done my own due diligence, having looked through some forums, some people who have claimed to have worked at Cobram Estate actually swear by the manufacturing process that they claim on their official site, and they say it's the real deal. And there's just some more information here on what polyphenols are and other contents of olive oil. Oleic acid, fat-free radicals, the peroxides. And here's another source that I was looking into acquiring for myself from WA, but it's all sold out. So clearly there's some people out there that also know of this. But on that note, to finish up talking about olive oil, because it's already been rather extensive, it's rather inexpensive, especially when you look at Cobram Estate for 25 AUD and what you get. Now, myself personally, I just take a small shot of it. You could say like your standard drink shot of the olive oil, and I do that before I eat. I've had some stomach issues in the past, stomach ulcers, and I actually find that it aids digestion. It also helps regulate and suppress my appetite to a degree. So when you're trying to count calories, when you're trying to maintain a certain level of food intake per day, having a shot of this, while obviously has calories of its own, it helps me to feel fuller quicker and with less, a smaller intake of food. So not only does it do that, it does have its nutrients, vitamins, antioxidants, it's good for hair, skin, nails, and overall it even aids digestion, so smooth passing through the colon. So $25, rather inexpensive if you're going down a weight loss journey, health journey, trying to achieve some sort of form of optimal self. Through health comes everything else that is good in a man's life, in any person's life, really. So look into this in your own time, or if you want more information, let me know in the comments. I can even like start doing videos about this with more information, perhaps some notes on hand, because this is just all off the tip of the brain. But Cobram Estate, again, if you are, like, I'm not sponsored by olive oil, but again, easy to access here over in Oz, and it's pretty darn good. So let's jump into this video. Let's have a laugh. Let's chill out. Like I said, I'll give you a moment. Grab a drink. It's going to be nice, easy, free-flowing. And yeah, love it or hate it when it comes to US politics, don't care an ounce about it. This upcoming election is going to have watered down residual effects all over the world, but in particularly to NATO countries, ourselves over in Australia. You might not think it matters, but it matters. So if you did watch the Donald Trump podcast, he actually said that he's going to put a stop to the war in Ukraine if he comes into power. So, it's essentially a conflict that impacts the globe, even though, say, Australia's not directly fighting in it. Just look at all the money that Australia has sent over there. Billions, all right, at this point. So, you can't say that there is no impact of, say, Donald Trump getting into office for us down in Australia. And if he can resolve a rather wide-scale conflict, as he claims he can if he comes into power, I'm all for it, and it's an impact on all of us. So, without further ado, let's chill out and watch some of this video, maybe even all of this video.
I'll say that to the Nelk boys.
It's our last chance.
If she wins, the country's finished.
You gotta fight for your right.
Got Ray-Bans on. I got the same sunnies. I was a bit annoyed by this taskbar down here at the bottom when I made it full screen. Why is that taskbar there? This has never happened. Yeah, I don't want to.
Good.
Oh my god.
What the?
No, don't call the cops.
I gotta break it up. I don't want to get this entire video. I've already spoken so much to get taken down because of that music. So maybe breaking it up helps. The algorithm won't recognize the tune.
You're not cooking dogs and cats.
You don't even address me by my pronouns.
They're a bunch of communists.
Are you trying to piss somebody off?
What?
Want me to get my gun out?
I'm with your favorite people, the Nelk boys. They're having a good time at my expense.
Alright boys, we have a crazy Nelk video. I know it's been a while, but we're gonna take you guys inside Trump Force One. This video is insane. Before we get into it, if you guys have not downloaded the PrizePicks app and tried it out, you guys have to try it out. Download it right now. You guys know me, I love firing on sports, and I've tried every single app when it comes to players, and you get 50 on what.
Oh, they always gotta do the plugins. It's how you make the money when you're in the big leagues.
Been a minute since I put this bad boy on. It's fun though, it feels good.
No,
it's like
Michael.
When you haven't for a few weeks, then you hit a nice drink. That's what it feels like right now.
What are you doing here today?
I have no part in this prank, but you know, if I have to step up, I will. So,
yeah, I don't think you will.
Never know.
You guys have seen us do this before. We did it when Biden was running last time. Now, Biden got his ass kicked out of the party. Harris is in charge now. So we have these Harris signs. We're in Trump territory here in Florida, South Florida, and we're gonna be putting these on people's lawns. I don't think they're gonna like it too much, so we'll see what happens.
How's it going, sir? How are you? I work for the Harris Walls campaign.
Oh, sorry, buddy. We're the other side. I'm Trump all the way, buddy.
Okay. Well, no, I'll just leave the sign there, though.
Well, it's not.
I like the contrast. He comes out with this rather aggressive vibe. It's almost like he came out staunch and looked staring the guy dead in the eye, and he's like, "Oh, buddy, we're on the other side." Like, the contrasting themes of this first guy alone is pretty hilarious, but it just goes to show that you can have a difference of opinion and just still be a normal and respectful dude. He's not full blowing this guy away for being Harris Walt's side.
Stay up in my yard.
Oh, okay. What they call people like you? They call you guys useful idiots.
Did you not see Lil Jon at the DNC?
Lil Jon? Listen, I'm not a political guy.
That's my sign. Dogs.
Hi.
Hello there. Hi. I work for the Harris and Waltz campaign. I'm just doing a little patrol of the neighborhood.
Take it off.
No, I'm gonna leave it there, cause.
No, you're not gonna leave it there.
Oh, why?
Because I can't stand them.
Do you not support tampons in men's bathrooms?
No, I don't support tampons in men's bathrooms.
Why?
Because tampons are for women. Where are they going to stick it up their ass? Get that out of there right now.
Well, I'm going to leave it there. Wait, that's my sign.
Hey, get it out of here.
Wait, don't touch my sign.
Get it out of my property.
That's my sign.
I don't give a shit. Get it out. And nobody told you to put it in my fucking property.
You don't even address me by my pronouns.
Piece of shit. They're a bunch of
Yes, people might look at that and think, oh, she's crazy. Oh, look at them, they're wild. I think people are just genuinely patriotic and passionate. They care about the country they're in. They care about the livelihood of like-minded people. Generally care about, I suppose, a majority of people. You can't say she wasn't respectful right off the bat. She just started getting pushed and pushed and pushed. Now, obviously, it's a prank, yeah. But she didn't just open the door and tell the guy to F off. Like, no thanks, go away, I don't want that on my property. He's trying to get a beta reaction out of her, but yeah, I don't think it's like particularly crazy behavior, and being passionate and patriotic at its core is admirable.
Address me by my pronouns.
What are you, he, she? Transgender, what you are.
I'm two spirit.
Don't ever put no sign up.
You don't care about democracy. You don't care about democracy. Okay.
I love it. I love American politics.
Jesus. Go. That's mom of the year.
All right, Salim, you're up, baby.
In contrast, how boring is our politics over here in AU? Like, the most we get of something like this is Lydia Thorpe throwing a tantrum. And everyone, for the most part, does just look at her like a segment out of Looney Tunes.
I just put... No, I'm gonna keep it there.
Listen, man, with all respect, please take your signs down.
Well, I work for the Harrison Waltz...
I don't care who you work for, man. I'm asking you with respect, and please take the signs off of my property.
No, well, I was just about to say, I'm gonna bring more signs, too. I'm just gonna place it around.
No, I know Wake Forest.
What is your issue, man? Come on, seriously. No, it's my property. Do you own this?
Well, no, I support Walt and Harris.
I respect you for that.
Daughter's got the camera out.
But we're just going to put it...
Any signs.
I know, but we just got to put it all around the property. We should just put it all around the property because...
Dude, you know what? You're going to get yourselves into trouble. Don't worry. Don't back
up. No, I'm just going to put it over here.
Get the...
For Kamala Harris and Walt.
I'm just going to tear the things up anyway.
But you don't support defunding the police?
No, I don't. Dude, are you trying to piss somebody off? Because that's what you're doing.
Well, the Waltz...
Want me to get my gun out? All right? And then you'll see who went about defunding the police.
You gotta support Kamala and Waltz.
I don't know who you think you are. What is your name? Let me see your license. What is your name?
Salim Harris.
Salim Harris. No, where do you live, Salim?
I don't know, honestly.
Right. Okay, so you're an idiot.
I'm gonna put 10 more there.
Yeah, and I'm gonna call the cops, and I'll tell them what the to do with your ass.
I'm sure they'll support it. Oh. Yo, go.
He's not getting a gun.
Go, he may want to shoot, bro.
No.
Yeah, we just left the sign there, though.
Come 2025. You better watch it because...
He's clearly got kids in the house. He's not just going to pull a gun out because it's the US and everyone's apparently crazy and just going to start shooting randomly because they got annoyed by someone being on their lawn. The dude's got a phone in his hand from the looks of it. Like, these Nelk boys, I know it's a prank, but far out. Like, even they're not portraying Republicans in, like, the best light. Like, everyone's just gonna get ticked off and they're going for their guns. But you have to be, like, a full outright idiot to pull out a gun on someone because you disagree with their ideals or even if they verbally abused you.
Around here,
yeah, I'll take the sign.
Somebody's gonna pull a gun on you around here.
Yeah, well, he's not doing himself any favors either. As I said, I think you're just a straight up idiot if you pull out a gun on someone for a difference in opinion. There's one thing to start, let's just say, verbally abusing one another and carrying on publicly. Hell. Maybe even having a tussle, all right? A bit of a fray. Street fight. Street beef style. But pulling guns, pulling knives, like, you're outright an unstable person.
Man, you did a hell of a job. Just gonna tell you that.
Thank you, sir.
Take your signs out of here!
That was
Trump,
awesome.
That's all I can tell you. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Be careful, brother. Be careful. I'm telling you guys.
It's a risky one.
That guy, he's got probably 25 guns in his house.
Yeah. 41 for the win. I've been scoring them buckets like I'm dreaming. Throw a shot if he's in the first one. I got put aside.
What's the matter if you got 25, 50, 60, 100? You're only going to shoot one at a time.
Alright, boys, so we just with some conservatives. Obviously, we're pro Trump, but we gotta put both sides. So we're in San Francisco. We got the house, and we also got this truck.
My mama always told me I would have a hiss.
Dude, this is gonna get me copyrighted, even though I'm not monetized. I just have to bypass this music. I don't know if they've got a license for it or what.
Nice trip, man.
Like
that's
it?
I'm talking about. Y'all representing that trip. That's what I'm talking about.
Hell
yeah. That new one, they taking away Section 8 and all kind of shit now, man. Like, that new girl, not making sense.
Have a great weekend.
Y'all beat Trump again, man. Y'all have a blessed one. Yeah.
You notice how charismatic some people are over in the US as well? You walk down the street wherever you're at, whether it's a rural sort of town, maybe like Ballarat, Bendigo style, a bit bigger, G-Town, Geelong, or you're just from Melbourne. The charisma on people's faces over in the US and just the outright variety of the different types of people. It's amusing and... Yeah, unless you are, like I said, becoming aggressive and threatening towards people. Yeah, it's just pretty cool to see. Like that dude just there, he was, he sounded like he was a Trump supporter, but he was just approachable and charismatic. And he sounded like it'd be fun to exchange banter with him. Whereas, yeah, a lot of people, let's say, even I come across in day-to-day life, struggle to string a couple of sentences together, and just overall there's not much substance or any sort of banter exchanges and fun and having a conversation.
Here's
so go to hell, go to this girl.
Go to hell, you go to hell.
What?
You
go to hell,
you. Yeah, there's a place in hell for you guys. There's a special place in hell.
Why hell?
Because it's like
she actually reminds me of this dude I had a bit of a Facebook argument with. It's not particularly up my alley to get really invested in arguing with what seemed to be a liberal over Facebook. I might get into that. It depends. If there's maybe more context than just this cue, I kind of wanted to use that as a bit of a cue to give my example of a liberal coming at me. He wasn't really like attacking, but he had such a twisted perspective on something. I'll tell you about it in a second. All right? Just stay tuned in. It won't be a bad one, especially if you're, you know, pro-Trump. You're a trad man, trad woman. You should be liking this video so far. I do dare say. And hey, if you're one of those people, actually, some people just flat out dislike some of my videos, and that's cool. I don't have a problem with that, but man, I'd like to see something in the comments section. Just tell me where the problem is. Is it because that you don't comprehend what I'm saying? There's too many big words for you. Yeah, all seriousness, all due respect. It'd be cool to know what the issue is.
We're here for the parade.
Cause like that chick just there, and like these bandies. A lot of people, I'm bypassing it because there was just music again, and
people are trying to drive you.
Yeah, a lot of people can't defend their position, whether it's a political position or a position on some sort of views that they have. If you have a strong, concrete position on something, a perspective, an outlook, a view on things, you should be able to explain it, and explain it in such a way that doesn't provoke you to get all emotive and emotional about it. Just have a logical conversation.
People are trying to drive.
Get out!
Fuck down. You notice they all look the same? They're all pretty much women or unhealthy. So if it's a dude, it'd be like one of them soy boys, just obese, fat, unattractive, and once or twice you might glimpse at a reasonably attractive female. But otherwise, there's just a recurring theme with the way that people like this look. Like, they gotta yell out, fuck you, get out, give the finger, and for what?
Trump. Yeah, nigga, fuck Donald Trump. Yeah, fuck Donald Trump.
Oh, like throwing shit. I bet, like, these guys got a bunch of Trump flags. It's a little bit provoking, but that's really the extent of it.
Yeah.
I bet if you even ask them, like, why they would vote for Harris, they probably wouldn't even be able to tell you their position or why so in 20 seconds. Like, they wouldn't be able to string more than a couple of sentences together at best, and even then, there'd be just, yeah, she's pro-abortion.
I just got a car wash!
Holy shit.
This is...
We're gonna do a little social experiment today.
We're gonna see what happens pretty much if we, just set up a Trump house in, like, the Bay Area.
If someone tries to take the sign, we have this water bucket contraption, because they gotta pay the price for entering private property. Private property is probably not even a thing in San Francisco, eh? There's no law and shit. You can shit on someone else's lawn.
I feel great.
Yeah, so if you don't know, San Francisco, there's various videos out there of the amount of homelessness and drug problems going on. There's people outright shitting on the street, in the middle of the street, like zombies walking around. I can't quite now remember the drug that they're on, but they actually look like a Hollywood depiction of a zombie. Be pretty funny if they get someone with a bucket, though. This is where you can just get on a pretty crazy, maybe I should just call it a Democrat because it's an interchangeable word, crazy and Democrat. You might get one of them and they'll get pretty done. They're already pretty mad if they're going to be trying to flip the sign and piss it off from someone's front lawn, like they said, entering private property. And if on top of that, you get them soaked in a bucket of water, someone might go crazy in this one.
Man.
Is the water too f***ed or what?
No, I don't think it's
at all.
You shouldn't be touching people's shit. Yeah, no, you shouldn't go on someone's lawn and take it off. True. Water's harmless too.
All right, we're set up here now. People have been giving us dirty looks. We're just gonna post the f*** up here. Might take a few hours. Hopefully someone tries to pull the sign out. Yank this rope.
Ozzy?
It's go time.
Should we go to the alley?
Go now.
Okay, let's go. All right, so we got a couple guys coming up to approach. Some guy's coming to the house right now.
Are you serious?
That's what you fucking get. Oh man. I can't just walk up to some trans or homo and pull their flag out of their arms, even though I disagree with what they're doing. They're just perverted people that go into the CBD in Melbourne and dress up in mankinis and do shows for kids. And that ain't even private property. Those freaks, for the most part, they're like in a public building sometimes, like a library.
They get you too?
Huh?
They get you too?
Yeah. It was like a big bucket of water
yeah.
hanging out a window, and when I pulled the sign...
I live right there. I tried to get rid of that sign. Because I hate Trump too. I just posted on Facebook, hashtag MAGA too, so we're set.
That sobered me up. I was a little hungover.
Yeah, same. Yeah, same. Should we just start cranking? Start cranking beers?
Oh, I'm good right now. I'm
football's on and shit. MAGA.
Problematic
production. He is like the pitch perfect emote representation of everything that is San Francisco ever since Biden took office.
What are you doing here?
Yeah.
We're just chilling.
Chomping
out this house.
Yes.
Are you guys renting this house?
No. It's my auntie's house.
It's your auntie's house. All right. Well, you guys won't mind if I call the police and they can figure out what's going on here.
Why would you call the police?
What?
It seems like an event. And
don't call the police because my auntie will get mad because she likes Kamala too. What does your shirt say? Sir.
I think it said Kamala with a cat.
Hello. How are you? We're just seeing how people in San Francisco react to a Trump house. Alameda, sir. Yeah.
You guys are not doing anything wrong.
No.
Absolutely
not. No. We drove around with that. Someone threw a water bottle at my head. I Floyd Mayweathered it.
That's cool. That's cool. Right.
Thank you, guys.
Pretty strong opinions, and I don't want to say the wrong thing, but all those people that, especially in the US, that scream for defund the police, just the first thing they do is, maybe not the first, but then they just go and opt and call the police for a disagreement of opinion. He wasn't even abused or told to F off. He, for everything that I just saw then, actually waltzed onto the property. So he was already, he wasn't outright told to get out of the property, get off the property, but you could say he was teetering on the fence there, metaphorically and literally speaking, that he was borderline, yeah, trespassing. Well, he would have been if he was told that he was trespassing. But anyway, your typical, oh, I disagree, I don't like this, cut it out, or I'm calling the police. Next minute, he's at a rally to defund the police. Oh, man, the copyright is going to go through the roof. We've been posting all these on Instagram, too.
So make sure you're following all of us on Instagram, because I post shit on my personal Instagram. Salim posts it, Nelk Boys posts it, so it's a tough one, man, to pitch to people, right? We didn't even tell you guys what we're doing, but yeah, so what we are doing is we're in Springfield, Ohio. You guys saw the viral clip of
I already know. Eating the dogs, eating the cats, eat the cat, eat the cat. That was such a catchy tune. I might be able to actually plug this into the side of the video. Eating the cats, eat the cat. I'm not sure yet. That might actually get me copyrighted, because that was viral.
Trump at the debate saying they're eating the cats and the dogs.
In Springfield, they're eating the dogs. The people that came in, they're eating the cats.
So we're planning on that today, and we have a cat and dog food truck, Wolf and Whiskers. It's probably gonna be a booming business out here too, if cats and dogs are being eaten. I'm gonna sell some cat and dog meat. I gotta take a piss in the woods. I don't think Trump's winning this county.
No, apparently he said he's coming here, and they were like, don't come.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. But we're here.
Who let the dogs out?
The hell is it?
Oh my goodness. The music. How do they keep getting away with it?
Dog or cat?
Huh, dog or cat? I'm not doing that.
What do you mean?
I'm not eating dogs or cats or any of that bullshit.
So it's actually her sister?
No.
It's Black Lab. Wait, sir, come back!
That's pretty funny.
Just give us a try.
That's our wolf. Huh? That's our wolf. It's delicious.
Sir, don't knock until you try it. Welcome to Wolf and Whiskers.
I don't know what you
We got dog or cat meat.
Neither one.
Have you ever tried it?
I'm not eating no dog or cat meat.
How much for your dog?
How much for your ass?
For my ass?
Yeah.
$5.
I'll shoot you for your... Oh my goddamn dog.
Sir, $1,000 for that dog. That thing looks tasty. Sir, it's supply and demand.
I'll go get you some dogs if you need them.
Some dogs?
I'll get you some animals.
Fast. Just get me one cat, because I mix them in with hamster meat too, because hamsters are way cheaper. Everyone's obsessed with the dogs and cats right now, but hamsters are next up.
How much you say a cat?
$1,000 a cat.
I'll get you 2 for $14.
Deal.
Hey, I'll have them in a box.
He's tripping on something as well. Half of these people so far in these videos aren't sober, whether it's alcohol related or some kind of drug.
Patricio.
Yeah.
Stop
okay.
Looking at my dog like that. I don't like that.
He looks
that.
Yummy though. I just want to bite him.
No. Arr.
Patricio, I need them alive. Welcome to Wolf and Whiskers. Would you guys want wolf or whiskers?
Okay, what's the special?
Dog or cat meat?
Alright. Right place.
Yeah, fresh dog. Shit was barking yesterday.
I want cat.
You want cat? Okay. We're out of cat.
Oh shit.
Let me get some delivered.
He was licking his lips, and there's no way that's staged. He's an amputee. I'm assuming he's a vet, maybe a Vietnam vet. What the heck?
Quick. Can I get some woof and some meow?
In order?
It looks a little bit too young for Vietnam, but I don't know what's going on here.
Quick! Get in here, get in. Don't do it in front of customers, bro. And tell the Haitians to stop me. I'll fly to Haiti. Sorry about that. So you want to try some? You want to try some wolf?
Yeah.
Okay. You guys ever tried dog meat before?
I have.
Where?
I think it was in Turkey.
Turkey? Okay. Well, this is American dog.
Yeah.
We don't f*** with that Turkish shit. Hits the spot, right?
Yeah, it does. Been better with cat though.
You like cat better?
Yeah.
Maybe they're going along with it. This guy just said, you know you are being videotaped, right? Unless he's saying that I'm videotaping you, though he's holding a box of dog meat, or at least that's what he's told he's holding a box of.
We're being videotaped?
Yeah,
oh my god.
See videotapes? He's in a passing to see
video. Never mind.
Should we run?
I don't know.
No, not the music again. Oh, how did it end with it? Is that how it ended?
You know what I mean?
How's it going? Welcome to Wolf and Whiskers. You guys want Wolf or Whiskers?
Dude, that vet didn't give a single shit. Yeah, I like cat better. Yeah, I had it in Turkey. Yeah, it's alright. I think he was, I'm going to go on a limb and say he just knew that wasn't dog or cat meat, and he was just going along with it. He was having a bit of an internal laugh.
One's dog and one's cat.
Surely.
Yeah.
Oh. No. Yeah, I'm not going to try that thing.
Hi. That's one order?
Oh, he's keen.
Customers.
My bad. Sorry.
I'll fly to Haiti. Sorry about that, guys. So you guys want woof or whiskers?
Let's see the meat.
If you don't leave, I'm leaving you.
If you don't leave, I'm leaving you. Dude, they got a kid together. Let the man have his dog.
Just got a little bit of samples here.
So it's actual dog?
Dog, yeah. It's like a stereo.
I'm ready to go. Come on.
I mean, supply and demand.
You gotta get Savannah away from there before I call police.
No, don't call the cops.
You're not cooking dogs and cats.
We already cooked them yesterday. They were barking yesterday.
That relationship is not going to work out. I reckon he smells that this is humor. This is some kind of prank. She's roaring over it. She probably did call the cops, and she is also going to vote for Kamala Harris. Oh, if you saw my other video, I said that sitting in the passenger side and putting your seatbelt on is feminine behavior. I was joking, but yeah, shit. He's going to have to play pretend and vote for Kamala Harris as well.
Bro. All right.
He probably does. He probably listens to everything she says.
We have bad luck in Ohio too, so let's get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, I can't walk in anywhere. Should I just wear this the whole day?
What's wrong with underwear,
my kid? It's wet. Nah, I dropped it in the puddle. I kind of like wearing an apron. Right.
They're eating the dogs. They're eating the cats.
Best.
Killing me with the music.
Spot to stay at. Shout out Tall, shout out Joe, shout out Hassan. All the butlers here, they're amazing. You got to stay at Red Rock. We are going to be doing Trump on the podcast for the third time. You guys saw the podcast. It's already out. It's going crazy. And then we're going to fly on his plane. So we're going to go on Trump Force One. We've already been on Air Force One. I sound like a cocky, but I mean, it is what it is. We're going to fly with him to a rally in Coachella, California. And then we're going to fly back. We don't really know what to expect. It's going to be a crazy day. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. We're going to take you guys along for the ride today. How you feel?
That's pretty cool. Donald Trump must be one of the first presidents to be so active on social media. Yeah, social media hasn't actually been around for that long. Now, I would know because it was in its... It was really infancy when I was younger, so I was around in the MySpace days. Yeah, I had a MySpace, and how you had the theme songs playing on the MySpace. Like, MySpace was big, and it was even before Facebook was invented, before it was a thing. And then eventually that became like a transitioning point where you had to go from MySpace to Facebook. As you got older, it was like being on Facebook, having a Facebook and ditching your MySpace was like a transitional point, a key point in adulting, right? This is like where you were getting out of your actual childhood. You were leaving your childhood behind when you transitioned to Facebook from MySpace. And tying all that in together, Donald Trump is really so active on social media, and I think for the most part that's a pretty good thing. He's really able to resonate and hit a target audience of young adults. I'm not all about getting into a debate of whether it's a good thing or a bad thing that say he's on TikTok and maybe he's even posting Instagrams as well, but that's what that generation's all about. Generation Z, Generation Alpha. It's like gone full circles, starting from the top again. What's the next generation? Bravo. In all seriousness though, I ain't about that. I'm not particularly on any social medias. I did have an Instagram, but funny enough, my Instagram actually got banned and deleted. Same with my real Facebook that had real people on it. And yeah, that was it. I got deleted for supporting pretty openly Donald Trump back in the 2020 elections. And I couldn't even appeal the ban. It's just, you are gone. And ever since then, I never really got back involved in social media again. But it's good to see Trump doing it. If he can hit a certain audience that otherwise he wouldn't be able to reach, and maybe they can watch and listen to him talk and feel that, yeah, I stand by his values, I stand by his policies that he will potentially bring into place, he's going to need every vote. I think this will be a tight election.
Doing good. Trump, baby. Trump.
My dad's in town too. We're celebrating his official retirement.
Right.
Ooh.
Official retirement. Yep.
Let's go. That's it.
So you're going to get to meet Trump too.
It's time. Yeah, I'm going to meet the man.
Me and Steiny are going to go on the plane with Trump. Salim's holding it down because we had a previous commitment already at Marquee. Happy Dad Day Party there. So shout out to Salim for holding it down. What's good at Marquee today?
Oh yeah, so there's a lot of Penn State birds. Penn State's my favorite.
No, fast forward a bit. It's uninteresting, really. That's cool though. His dad's gonna meet Trump. And they've done 3 podcasts, Nelk said. It's probably a bit of an overabundance. I've watched the Trump one with Theo Vaughn. I thought that was actually alright.
I said, don't tell me Bob's in this one.
We put Bob on the sidelines.
Good just call. Just for this one, just for this one.
Yeah, good call.
What's up?
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Guys, my father, Harvey. Thank you to Steiny's dad, Harvey, for all the free legal representation he's done for Nelk.
Let me interrupt you. Ain't nothing free.
Not free. It's not why Steiny's in Nelk, but it's a big factor.
What do you think about Steiny interviewing the president?
It's quite amazing, actually. What a country we live in.
I thought I was going to be shit.
I've been wrong once before.
I live for these moments like this. It's like a...
Yeah, that's something you will never see, or at least haven't seen. Our politicians in Australia actually getting involved with younger generations. It doesn't have to be like Generation Z. Even millennials, such as myself. Dudes in their 30s. Early 30s, mid 30s. Just sitting down, having a little bit of an exchange. Talking that red pill. Talking maybe some of that black pill talk. Whatever the pills. I've said in other videos, I'm not particularly aware of what pill is what. But a bit of like transpiring talks of masculinity and ideals and hitting some bases that are relatable, I think, to younger men especially. But when you look at our politics in AU, it's just this straight face, overall left-leaning rather talk of just making sure that the other side stays happy and just bending over for the other guys. You know, we'll just go along with it. We'll just make sure that they're happy. And it's always so politically correct. It's uninteresting. And by trying to be this overall nice guy, which we'll just say our Prime Minister is trying to be, it's boring, without substance, without character, without charisma. There's nothing particularly to follow or give a shit about, quite frankly speaking, because you can already tell that he's just trying to be appropriate to everyone that he meets, and it's always this vague and rather simplistic take on things just to make sure that he's covered all of his politically correct bases. As Joe Rogan said to Eddie Bravo today, actually, I was watching a bit of that Fight Companion live podcast. Joe Rogan said, I just want to sit Kamala down and ask her some straight up questions. Like, what are you all about? Just talk to her about her, not her policies and what she's going to allegedly put into place. And that's what I'm getting at too. It's all this boring talk where you feel like you're teetering around all these sort of irrelevant issues and all these sort of promises that they never come to fruition. We've seen it here in Oz time and time again. If you're a Victorian, all the promises from the biggies, D. Andrews, and it's kind of just where it stops. Again, there's no substance to it. There's nothing interesting, nothing people can resonate with to actually see, say, a man's character who's in a position of power.
Flu game for me. I felt like shit last night. I got food poisoning. Battled through it.
We're going to do a quick prayer with Girls Gone Bible. You're not even Christian, though.
No, there's no joke about it. Well,
he's a nose. I'm not sure if he can. He's Jewish. You're not even Christian. What did they say? Girls Gone Bible.
We can make. We all have one God.
Man, they're attractive. I gotta look it up. Girls Gone Bible. We'll let it play for a bit.
This is an absolute honor to share this room with everyone here, including the Girls Gone Bible. Females, you all look amazing. Please, God, give us the strength to make this thing great.
Is that Bradley Martin? He's a bit of a gimp with some of his podcasts. I'm surprised that he hasn't asked Donald Trump, would you beat me in a street fight? I'm 260, bro. I'm 260. Is that what he's... I think it's 260, yeah. I'm 120 kilos, basically. Do you reckon you beat me in a street fight? He asks that to everyone he has on his podcast. I almost wrote Girls Gone Wild. Probably would have opened up some porn site. Girls Gone Bible. Okay, so it's like an Instagram kind of thing. Who are Girls Gone Bible? Podcast. Okay, with these two girls here. It's blurry now on screen, but... Number one ranked religion and spirituality podcast. The more you know. The more you know, and yeah, if it's... authenticious and sincere, genuine, and they're practicing Christians, all the power of God to them. Much respect. And yeah, if they're taking this prayer seriously, then I'm humbled. It's very good to see. People should maintain their culture, their faith, their spirituality.
Greatest interview we've ever done.
Yeah.
And if we're lucky, allow us to please have dinner with the Girls Gone Bible girls after this.
Bro, it's not a joke. Come on.
Okay.
I like that. Even Brad Martin, it is Bradley Martin. He pulls them up. Like, come on, man. It's not a joke. But if they're single, hey, they're attractive women. It ain't simping to say they're attractive women. And I actually find that really attractive as well about women when they are spiritually grounded. Yeah, when they have a deeper and higher sense of purpose. And that speaks... miles and decibels about their values, outlook on life, their moral principles. It's very attractive.
Please give us the strength to make this the biggest podcast in the world. We are so grateful to have this moment to share it with all of our best peers.
And on that note, like, even what they're wearing, you don't need to hypersexualize yourself as just about every fucking woman with a good body thinks that you need to do, all right? You need to wear those gynecological pants. It's just eating your snatch. It's going all the way in there. You've got every single curve and line showing. The pants are just crawling up your asshole, right? It's like a lifesaver and you're trying to poke your tongue through it. You can look really attractive well and still be dressed in a modest, conservative way that outlines your assets, your features, your womanly figure, your curves, we'll call it. And you can uphold respect and dignity within yourself and still look like a beautiful person.
To interview the greatest former and about to be reelected Donald Trump. In Jesus' name I pray.
Can I just say something?
Yes, please.
God, I pray for these boys. Would you bring them so far into your heart and protect them and deliver them from all evil? In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Let's break bread after this, huh?
If you guys are watching, you've already seen the pod. It came out last week, but this is our setup. President Trump always needs a monitor. He likes to see his angle, so we always got the monitor for him. Brad, you nervous?
I'm a little, I'm not gonna lie, I'm never nervous ever interviewing anyone.
I haven't seen this podcast. I gotta have a look at it just to see if Bradley Martin asked Donald Trump, "Dragon, you beat me in a street fight."
Yeah.
How deep are you about to get?
You're gonna step up and touch him.
I'm gonna touch his knee. I'm gonna touch his knee. Step up and give him a knee tap.
Here they are. Big stars. Big stars.
Is the D wearing high-waisted pants? That's such old-school men's fashion. I actually got to get me some high-waisted pants. It's a timeless classic look, all right? It's not some Harry High Pants bullshit. I reckon high-waisted pants actually look pretty good with suspenders on. It's a pretty classical, gentlemanly-like outfit.
Look at the arms of this insane man.
President Trump, back on the podcast.
What do you take away from Kamala having a beer with Stephen Colbert?
Probably drank Bud Light, too. Great or great again, Jimmy Kimmel?
Jimmy Kimmel's a loser. I'm hearing it's big.
We all know your rallies are the biggest.
I like this guy. Yeah, he's a nice guy. Now, if you don't vote for Trump, don't vote.
Don't vote.
Thank you, Trump.
Be proud of you boys.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
You might have caught a glimpse of that. He has a really elaborate signature. Like, mine's looks like scribble in contrast to that. And a lot of people's do. That's like a piece of art, that signature he just put on that.
Best chart in the world.
That's the best in the world.
Oh, yeah. Are they going already?
Hey.
Pod's done. We're headed to the plane now. We're going to fly with Trump.
Man, that would be so fun. Just asking Donald Trump and talking to him like a normal person with respect and upholding dignity, but at the same time just laid back, cruising through it, probably asking him some fun like questions. You can get a bit serious, but for the most part just keep it relaxed, and it's where someone's like charisma and humanity can really shine through. Again, it just comes back to that point I was making where you just don't want to talk to some of these politicians and you find them so uninteresting because they're not relatable. There's no human aspect to them, and you feel as though everything they say is just filtered and down-regulated to appeal again to the masses and sound correct. These songs are gonna get me copyrighted and the video taken down.
Alright, we've been on Air Force One, like I said, in 2020. Not many people can compare the two, especially a Canadian. I wonder how many Canadians have been on Air Force One and Trump Force One.
That's crazy.
Maybe none.
Damn, that was badass. I gotta go back and check that AR-15 setup out that old mate Secret Service had.
People can compare the two, especially a Canadian. I wonder how many Canadians have been on Air Force One and Trump Force One.
That's crazy.
Cool. There's even a tailor-made suit jacket. Winds are not. I can't see his belt. I just wanted to see if his watch strap leather matches his belt. And I can't see the color of his shoes. Just critiquing this guy's Secret Service guy's outfit. But it's a well-fitting jacket.
Maybe not.
Man, I swear this won't be uploaded without copyright, or it's a miracle.
Better.
nicer than
Air Force?
I think so.
I think it's nicer than Air Force One.
Think they serve drinks on here or not?
Oh, ask. Do you guys serve drinks on here?
No alcohol.
So. No alcohol?
No.
What a weird question to ask.
Yeah? Why would you ask that, bro?
It's the president.
Imagine taking down a flag.
How are they even asking that when they've had Trump on apparently 3 podcasts? Even I know that Trump doesn't drink, and according to him, never has, and doesn't let any of his sons drink, which they might. I think Junior might, but yeah, Trump doesn't drink. Why would then he have alcohol on his own jet? He's heavily against it. Imagine if Trump brought back the era of prohibition, alcohol's just outlawed, straight banned, no alcohol for anyone in the country.
The song is definitely not bad in this
year. I mean, how long has this plane been around?
Thank you.
That music again, given out like, look like a repackaged McDonald's.
Every day?
Yeah.
Trump Force One cockpit.
Yeah, we got the,
oh, look!
Trumpinator with the
I don't know, maybe because it's in the background, the music. I'm just really paranoid. Like I said, I don't know if these videos are ultimately going to get uploaded. And I've already done so much of it. There's no way I'm then going to sit down and re-record this and pretend like I'm watching it for the first time. But yeah, the whole notion was just to have a chilled kind of sesh here. It's pretty productive, actually, on my end. I get to watch and experience a video I probably would have watched in my own time anyway. But now I get an upload out, too. And potentially entertain you on a Sunday night to a degree.
There we go. All right, thank you, guys.
You're welcome. Here comes up.
It's nice. Yeah, the best most of us have ever had is sitting there with 6 inches of space in between our knees and the seat in front. 6 inches? You'd be lucky if it was 3.
Alright, we just landed in Coachella. Last time I was here, I went on a 3-day bendy. Different type of Coachella trip this time.
Yeah.
Yo, this actually really looks like Coachella. It's like tents and shit. This is interesting.
Yeah, I'm so cooked with this music, surely. I've brought that up so many times now, but you have to understand I'm mildly paranoid, alright? I try and take care and effort with these videos, and I want them to come out there.
Do you guys have any left? I could go for one right now, man.
So could I. They're amazing. Thanks for creating those.
It's really not much going on. I'm pretty much done with it too, I think. But, okay. Trump.
It's crazy, right?
Yo, you're talking to my girlfriend.
Sure. Huh?
You're my girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, we're good.
They're with us.
I don't think so. Not for much longer.
Did they have a good time?
Oh yeah.
The speech was awesome. That was 101,000.
Yeah. It was bigger than the festival.
No, that's the same. Oh, bigger than the festival. You like this?
Freddie Mercury's the best.
Somebody just handed me this one, a bobblehead from Las Vegas. And we honor Dana White.
Yes.
We love him. I'll give you guys hats. You have these?
Perfect. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
You want a drink?
I'm okay.
Scotch?
No.
He's offering scotch now? They said they don't have any alcohol on board. And Trump has said multiple times himself he doesn't drink. If he's going to drink scotch now in this video, I might have a different outlook on the man. Because he has outright said that I've never partaken in alcohol.
So I've got 32 days with zero break. And we have another 23 days.
It looks like he's got a rollie there on the table next to the hat. He's just about to roll some tobacco. He's just got it prepped. I remember like seeing the Irish boys when I was working as a security guard. They just have it all out there. They'd have the pouch with the tobacco and they'd have the rollie paper there. Looks like he's just getting ready to roll a cig.
Then I'm going to go with zero break. In theory, you should collapse. but I view it different now. I would feel very guilty if I sat home doing nothing, one day or 2 days out of 23, and the prize is the presidency, and making America great again, right? And people say, oh, no, no, you should take it, right? She takes 2-3 days off a week. I couldn't do that. It's too important.
Speaking of Kamala, I know you don't like her, but that's Kamala's greatest achievements. That's very good. I love
it. They're always working. Show it to them. That's good.
They're watching this video. He's putting a sign, a Kamala sign outside.
I gotcha.
Hello there. Hi. I work for the Harris and Waltz campaign. I want to... Do you not support tampons in men's bathrooms?
Tampons are for women. Where are they going to stick it? Up their ass? Get it the f*** out of here.
It was fire. It was...
We put it up on my show.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
Good. All right. Well,
look,
rally
out. Do it now.
Yeah?
Do it.
That's so cool. See what I mean? Can you imagine someone like Anthony Albanese doing anything remotely of that caliber? I don't think that man's ever made anyone laugh who's under 50 years old.
Get it up. That's a new one. That's a new
one. Oh, is that
a new
one? Yeah.
You couldn't act it as good as
him. No.
No. See, these are modern day stars.
Sleeping.
No callback. I'm with your favorite people, the Nelk boys. They're having a good time at my expense. They're having a good time on my plane. We just landed. It's a little rougher landing. It's a little rougher landing than Data would ask. So I'm here with your friends, the Nelk boys, and they are the modern day Johnny Carson, right? I can't say Jimmy Kimmel and these losers.
No, we're good.
You know, they have no ratings. How much he hates me. Where did we land? I don't know. Where are we
now?
I didn't know we're in Vegas. I don't even know. This was a great rally.
Great rally.
Yeah. I had to put out a little extra because I had the Nelk boys, the freaking Nelk boys. I had everybody in Hollywood there. This was the craziest. You had a good time, fellas.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, do you want to say something?
What's up, Dana?
Hey, buddy, what's happening?
What's going on?
You guys have
fun? Oh, yeah.
Well, I let him ride in the plane, Dan. I don't let too many people ride in the plane, I'll be honest with you. I don't want to wear out. You know, I have very good leather. I don't want to wear it out with these guys. With their jeans, with the buttons on their jeans and stuff. I don't like it against my leather, actually. Anyway, but when is your next fight, please? Hey, Dan, we need a little entertainment here.
Abu Dhabi card's amazing.
John Jones. What time are we leaving tomorrow, fellas?
10 in the morning.
10.
10. Want to come over?
All right,
Dana, you know it's too early. Sleep. No, no, sleep. I'd love to have breakfast. For the first time in about 10 years, I watch boxing. When you get used to the other stuff, it's very slow. Not the same thing, you know.
The other stuff.
So, Dana, you are the greatest of all time. We all love you. We want to call you and break your choppers. What time do you get up in the morning generally, Dana? Like 1 in the afternoon?
8:30.
You know, I talk about Biden. Here's one thing I don't have. He goes to the beach every day. You know those little aluminum chairs that they're meant for children and old people because they're so light. They weigh about 3 ounces. He puts his head back and he's sleeping within like a minute. And I said, I wish I had that ability.
Yeah, same.
How about a guy goes to the beach at 82 in a bathing suit almost every day? This is not going to be a great... Do you think President Xi of China does that, Dana? I don't think so. These guys are great. I think they're extremely happy with the treatment I gave them. Hello, Dan. I'll talk to you tomorrow.
You can't say that's not charismatic. The man is funny. He's not going to be... busting your balls, laugh out loud on the floor rolling. It's not a raffle kind of funny, but there's sarcasm, there's good instinct for humor, there's charisma and charm. It's pretty appealing.
You're the greatest. So long. We gotta win, yeah. The country's finished. If she ever won, this country is finished. And I'll say that to the Nelk boys.
It's our last chance.
If she wins, the country's finished.
Yeah, I think so too, because I just remembered that I spoke about this earlier, about this dude on Facebook, and now that the video is pretty much wrapping up, I have to touch back on that. If you're still here... Alright, so this was a post of Mia Khalifa, the porn star, divorced her husband, right? And a dude here basically posts, she's got more honor than our US servicemen. So basically people in the Army, Air Force, Marines, etc. There's more honor in what she's done in the past and doing now currently for a living than what our US men in service now, I'm assuming he means women, just overall military. And there's quite a little bit here. I'm not gonna probably go into anywhere near as much of as there is actually content here, or exchanges I should say. But yeah, he goes along the lines of, there's nothing honorable about fighting for an evil empire and doing the bidding of bankers. I basically told him the soldiers that are there fighting, they're not the ones that are doing bidding of the bankers, right? They're not the ones that ask to be there. I've said that there is a few among them that are strictly there looking for a legal way of killing people. Okay, they want to be in the thick of it. But for the most part, I said here as well that soldiers just want to get home. And I made a point in saying that, look, you can dispute the truth any way you want, but the nation that you're living in and have the privilege of being a citizen of and everything that comes with it, including commenting this and using your iPhone, you wouldn't have any of that. And America as a nation wouldn't exist without its military. So as much as you want to shit on the men fighting for it, standing ready to fight for it, and irrespective of your perspective and views of what they're actually fighting for. And mind you, by the way, when Donald Trump was in power, there wasn't a single US serviceman killed over in Afghanistan for over 18 months. So they had the longest run of casualty-free events. And where this guy just totally showed his true face and his absolute liberal mindset. Again, I'm skimming over it, but this is just a vital point that he made, which was just crazy. Absolutely crazy here. Oh, now I have to find it, because other people got involved and other people just started blasting this dude that he's a fucking weirdo. Wow, okay. A lot of people have given this guy shit, so it's kind of hard to find. Now I'm scrolling through quite a few comments here. One guy's like, have you ever been touched by a girl? Now, that's a bit of an immature argument. Like, don't go down that route if you're going to have like a discussion, especially a serious one with people. Oh, here we go. If I was serving as I have done, apparently is what he's saying, as I have done with my buddies in the past, and I could see that they were serving an elitist empire, I would advise them against it, but otherwise I would have to shoot them in the back and then surrender myself to the enemy. And there's actually people that are doing like the thumbs up and the carry act with the heart to a comment like that. Dude, that's fucking crazy. This guy apparently claiming that he also served is saying, oh, well, if I don't agree, he's the kind of bitch ass, and I do sincerely mean that, he's the kind of bitch ass to rat on his mates, as we've had here in Australia, people narking on 2 Commando and Ben Robert Smith, the whole defamation thing. You don't even know. You don't even know. And for those guys ratting, you're amongst wolves, all right? They didn't come and knock on your door and recruit you. You chose to be there. All right? Wolves have to roll with the pack. That's ultimate betrayal right there. Whether you agree with what your comrades are or aren't doing, all right? No one grabbed you and brought you there. You're there. And for the most part, especially in the special operations community, most guys know what they're there to do. I'm not going to go down the rabbit hole of rights and wrongs and human violations, etc. But largely they know what the expectation of them is and why they're there. But anyway, this guy just, yeah, straight up says, yeah, if I had a, that's fucking dangerous, man. And he's just saying this openly. And then there's people outright heart care reacting. He's saying he would shoot people in the back if they didn't listen to him. He's not saying I would shoot them in the back if they were committing war crimes, if they were just walking up to women, children, fuck, even men, just outright executing them. No, he's saying if they didn't listen to me, I would shoot them in the back. Dude, that's fucking crazy, alright? This is probably not going to come up. Apparently, this guy's got 2,500 followers and he's a copywriter. Bro, like, he's got to be, like, pointed out, like, fucking, he probably can't see that, because I can't see myself. Gives people with long hair a bad reputation. Fucking piece of shit. Unstable. Outright unstable and straight up crazy to talk like that. I would shoot people in the back for disagreeing with them. And as I said earlier in this video, if you can't contain yourself that much for having a difference of opinion. And I've had this in the past where I would comment something, even like say on an athlete's performance and say tennis that I like to watch. And people will get so defensive, so quick to say that defend like a certain tennis player's honor. Because again, I've got like a difference of opinion. And probably you can tell I'm rather constructive with my feedback. I don't start going on a verbal tirade and insulting people. So, oh, you never touched the girl, stuff like that. Right? I genuinely keep it pretty civil and mature, constructive, right? And if you can't then sustain constructive discussion, give constructive feedback, you have to elevate your emotions, get offensive even, take constructive comments that say someone's giving so harshly that you get amped up and then openly make threats. I'm not particularly worried by threats. People can tell me that they want to kill me and all that kind of shit, and I don't care. I'm not per se bothered by it, but it goes to show the person's maturity and insecurity, their instability rather, of how they can't contain themselves. And that's another thing about being a strong man, being a likable man, being a gentleman, is being able to have your emotions in check. And then when you put yourself out there, when you make a case for something, an argument, or have a position, a view, an outlook on things, you need to be able to constructively defend it. And part of that is also lowering your ego and then being able to accept when someone else makes, say, a certain point that challenges you, and maybe assess as well that, okay, there's some truth to it, or they're outright correct. I stand corrected. Say something like that back at them. Yeah, okay, I stand corrected. I see what you're saying. I hear how you're saying it. Yeah. Okay. Sure. Maybe you need some time to then be able to formulate your argument. It's not like everyone's got these incredible debating skills where they can think on the spot, oh, okay, fire back at them. I mean, there's a reason debating is a skill and there's people that do it professionally, but if someone says something and you really think it through and there's nothing that you can say, don't have such a big head and ego to concede that, yeah, they challenge my opinion. We've got a difference in views, but for the most part, they actually corrected me. And there's nothing wrong or demasculating about sometimes admitting that you were in the wrong. But so many people walk around with this fucking overly inflated, huge ego and highly emotionally charged all the damn time that they make wild comments like this guy did. And they can vote. And they're out there in society. They potentially own a gun. And then other people look at them and fucking love heart react like that's normal to communicate like that online, right? With a guy over in Australia. It's wild.
It's totally finished.
That's why if you're watching, get up off your ass and vote. Don't just talk about it. Get out and vote. That was crazy. Trump is the man. There was a second where I didn't know if that was real life. I swear
what?
To God.
What is life?
I can't even believe this shit no more. Thank you guys, seriously. I mean, this is just surreal. It shit just gets crazier and crazier, but we'd be seriously nowhere without you guys just watching us for this long. It's been 12 years of Nelk, and it's all because of you guys. We might have to go sell it.
12 years, and this is my first time watching a Nelk Boys video. Not including a short that I may have run into, or a snippet, or a react that someone else has done, but actually first time watching a proper Nelk Boys video, and yeah, it was rather entertaining. I think previously I would have thought they're just liberal-minded young men, and we don't particularly have any contrasting views or anything in common, but yeah, it was rather entertaining. I think they're pretty charismatic, and overall, there was some funny skits and moments there. It was good. I'll probably subscribe.
Celebrate. We have to. Thank you, bro.
Let's go.
It's gonna change my life.
Let's go.
Shout out to John. If you guys are new here, make sure you subscribe. So in about 2 weeks, we're going with Forrest Galante to an uncontacted tribe 2 hours off the coast of Fiji. It's gonna be crazy. So stay tuned for that video. And then we're going to Australia after. So we got two big Nelk videos coming up.
Oh, that's sick. That tribal contact video next to Fiji and coming to Australia. Okay, maybe if they come to Melbourne City, I will check out from the online world and venture down, have a look at the Nelk Boys. Nah, it'll probably be some really big ticketed event. These guys are big with 8 million subs, and we'll just add ourselves amongst that list. It'd be pretty crazy to get in and see them, but I like their concept. It seemed a lot more chilled out and relaxed, and something a little different today with my video as well. It's not just harping on about same old women this, women that. There's life outside of it, and we had a little bit of fun. So yeah, if you're watching this Sunday evening, I hope you enjoyed. You had a good day, you had a good weekend overall. God bless you and yours, and all the very best for the week ahead. See you soon.